Hello, and thank you for watching. My name is Rachel Barnett with Gentle Frog. I'm here to create videos for you to help you understand QuickBooks slightly better than you currently do. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please put them in the chat box. Thank you.
In this video, I want to demonstrate what happens when you take two accounts, specifically bank accounts, and merge them together. This wouldn't be an example if it wasn't for the fact that both of these accounts are reconciled. This is a situation you're likely to encounter, so if I show you what it's going to do and what it's going to look like, then you'll at least know. So I've got account number new 1900 and account old 1900. And let's just say we want everything to be under the name of new 1900. That means I need to rename old 1900. Let me go back just to make sure I remember where this left off. I just grabbed a screenshot. Old 1900 is reconciled through October, and new 1900 is reconciled through February. I think that's going to be important in a minute, because when we merge them together, it can't have both reconciliation dates. It doesn't make any sense. So we go to the chart of accounts. We change old to say new. So edit, just replace old with new. It should say you're about to merge. Oh, what did I do? Oh, there's not a space. Oops. Okay, so we'll do that. Put a space in, save, yes to the merging, save again. So now I just have the one account. I have new 1900. When I click on view register, it says that it's reconciled through February, but you'll notice that my October stuff is still here and it's still showing reconciled on the right. When I go to click on reconcile, it says I'm off by $800. That's awesome. Let's look and see what we can help you fix, it says. It says these things are reconciled in the register. You watched me. Maybe my editor will cut out like one mistake, but I did not go through and click the R's. So to fix this, I'm just going to uncheck the R. So this save. Yes, I want to modify it. I'm beginning to wonder if I'm actually unchecking it. Okay, so let's click on done. So my statement date, when I click on it, it says my balance is $93. When I go to bank register and I go to reconcile, my starting balance is $93. When I look at the register, I undid the R's for the things from October. I basically undid the R's for the things that were in the old 1900 account. That was fine because I only had three. If you're in a situation where you have lots and lots of stuff, you're going to need to think very slowly and carefully about how you're going to address this before you merge stuff together. Everything is case by case, especially in a situation like this. So I'm not going to prescribe an answer. I'm just demonstrating here's what happens so that I can show you, so you can think about, like, what am I going to do? If you're ever in a situation where you're like, oh, I want to test the ideas and make sure I don't make a mess out of things, you can always Google QuickBooks Online test drive, get to the sample QuickBooks file, and recreate your situation. Make two bank accounts with a similar number. Throw some data in both accounts. Doesn't matter if it's right or wrong, it's just testing. Merge the accounts together and see what happens. Experiment. If I merge the old account into the new account, if I merge the new account into the old account, what if I, you know, unselect my R's? Like, just look at different scenarios. If you're ever in a situation where you need my help, I'm more than happy to help. You just hop on my calendar. We can work through stuff. I'm not going to know the answer off the top of my head, even if I look at your books. I'm going to need to take a moment, sit back and think about it, probably come into my sample file, recreate something similar, see what's going to happen before we do it with your real data. So that's it. Just me demoing a thing in case it's helpful. Thanks.